Good morning, students. So today we'll start this third unit, moment distribution method. We have completed the second unit, slope deflection method. So now moment distribution method. So in moment distribution method, you have the following things in syllabus: stiffness and carryover factors, distribution carryover of moments. So these are the basics which we'll cover today. Analysis of continuous beams, plane rigid frames with and without sway, support settlement. Support settlement, you already know. Support displacement in the previous unit, the same thing. Symmetric frames with symmetric and skew symmetric loadings. So you have continuous beams and rigid frames as we solved in the slope deflection method. And there is one different thing: symmetric frames with skew symmetric loading. That is a new thing which is added in this syllabus. The previous syllabus it was not there. We'll see it later. Okay, now coming to the introduction part. So we have seen slope deflection method. In slope deflection method, we use equations. So equilibrium equation, form the equilibrium equations, then we solve the simultaneous equations to get the unknowns, which is theta, primarily theta or the rotation. Now here, moment distribution method, there is no solution of simultaneous equations. So this method permits to avoid completely the solution of simultaneous equation with several unknowns. Okay, and this was introduced by Hardy Cross in the year 1932. This is an iterative technique. You keep on repeating. You have iterations until you get the satisfactory answer. And these are some of the basic concepts. Fixed end moments. So fixed end moments as in the previous method, slope deflection method. Same formula, no change. But you have different terms like relative stiffness, carryover and distribution factor. So coming to relative stiffness, so first of all, what is stiffness? So stiffness is nothing but the force required to produce unit deformation. If the moment is a force, moment required to produce unit rotation. Force, displacement, moment, rotation. I already told in the induction class. And torque, if it is torque, it is twist. So relative stiffness or stiffness is the force required to produce unit deformation, moment required to produce unit rotation and torque required to produce unit twist. So let us see a case. So case 1, that is AB. A is a roller support, B has a fixed support. So if you consider AB, A is a near end. So what will be B? B is a fore end. So what is this case? Fore end fixed. So now stiffness K will be equal to 4EI by L. Okay, so 4EI by L if it is a fore end is a fixed support, and relative stiffness will be equal to I by L. Okay, so relative stiffness equal to I by L. Now case 2, fore end hinged. See the diagram. So A is roller support, B is a hinge support. So in this case, stiffness K equal to 3EI by L, but relative stiffness will be equal to 3 by 4 I by L. So it is 3 by 4 I by L, not EI by L. Okay. So 3 by 4 I by L. So fore end fixed, relative stiffness equal to I by L. Fore end hinged, relative stiffness equal to 3 by 4 into I by L. So now K is proportional to EI and K is also proportional to 1 by L. Sorry, K is inversely proportional to the span L. Now let us see what is carryover. Now first let us see what is the effect of applying imaginary moments at a specified point. So this is a concept in moment distribution method. You imagine that you are applying a moment. So see here, this case 1, fore end fixed. A is a roller support, B is a fore end. AB, so B is a fore end fixed. So if you apply a moment M at the end A, so that is applied moment, then fore end at the fore end B, it will develop a moment of M by 2. So the reaction moment is M by 2. If you are applying a moment at A, the reaction moment is M by 2. Now this moment M by 2 is called carryover moment. And the factor 1 by 2 is called carryover factor. So what is carryover theorem? The reaction moment M by 2 at the end B due to the application of moment M at A is called the carryover moment. So for this, B has to be fixed. That is understood. Or you can add here at the end B within brackets, B is fixed. So the principle is called carryover theorem and you can have the diagram. So this I have given at the back. So now you understand for end is fixed, you'll have carryover moment as m by 2 and the carryover factor is 1 by 2. Now second case, if the for end is hinged, there is no carryover moment. Carryover moment is 0, so carryover factor is also 0. So carryover theorem, if you are writing it, you have to write the diagram, you have to write for only a for end fixed case. Okay, you have to draw the diagram only for end fixed. Again, coming to distribution factor. So distribution factor, the formula is relative stiffness of an individual member by total relative stiffness at a joint. So in a joint, there will be several members. So relative stiffness of each individual member by the total relative stiffness. So K1, K2, K3 are the individual relative stiffness. And the summation is K1 plus K2 plus K3 and so on till Kn. So it is summation K. So distribution factor will be K1. Distribution factor of member 1 will be K1 by summation K. Now you consider a joint here. Consider a joint A to which several members AB, AC and AD are connected. And the external moment, an external moment of M is applied at A. So it produces rotation of theta. So if a rotation theta is given to the joint A by an external moment, the rotation of each member will be also equal to theta. So rotation same for all the members. But the moments MAB, MAC and MAD will be in the ratio K1 is to K2 is to K3. So MAB will be equal to K1. So if the stiffness of MAB equal to K1. See, stiffness of MAB equal to K1, MAC equal to K2 and MAD equal to K3. So MAB equal to K1 by summation K into moment. So the moment is distributed in the ratio K1 by summation K. So M may be equal to distribution factor into M. So that is a distribution factor. So it is the factor by which the total moment is distributed among the individual members at a joint. So MAC will be K2 by summation K into M. MAD equal to K3 by summation K into M. Okay. The factors KI. So it may be 1, 2, how many members it is connected. It depends on the number of members. The factors Ki by summation K are called distribution factors. And MAB, MAC and MAD are called the distributed moments. So this was about the distribution factor. Now we'll see an example for distribution factor. See this example, a beam, a continuous beam ABC. Continuous over support B. So end support A is fixed and end support C is hinged. So for AB, I equal to I only, and for BC it is 2I. And the span of AB equal to 4 meter, span of BC equal to 3 meter. Now we can calculate distribution factors for BA and BC members. So always distribution factor only at the intermediate joint. So here the intermediate joint is B. So joint B, what are the members? BA and BC. You should write it as BA and BC, not AB and CB. Okay. So B is a joint under consideration. So similar to equilibrium equations, we write in slope deflection equation. BA and BC. BA, B is a joint under consideration. So B is a near end, A is a for end. What is a for end? A is fixed. So what is the formula of relative stiffness? I by L. So I by 4, I equal to I, L equal to 4. And for BC, what is a for end? C is a for end, it is hinged. So what is the formula? 3 by 4 into I by L. Again, I equal to 2I here, you have to be careful. And L equal to 3 meters. Substitute the values, you get 2I by L. 2i by L, I'm not reducing to I by 2 because it will be easy to add. BA, relative stiffness equal to I by 4. So this let it be 2i by 4. So total relative stiffness, see. Total relative stiffness, I by 4 plus 2i by 4, you'll get 3i by 4. Now, distribution factor, what is the formula? Distribution factor, the formula is relative stiffness of the member by total relative stiffness. So relative stiffness of BA equal to relative stiffness of BA, which is I by 4, relative stiffness of BA is I by L. So that divided by total relative stiffness. Total is 3I by L. For BA, relative stiffness I by 4. So I by 4 divided by 3I by 4. So again, multiply, you'll get 1 by 3. So distribution factor of BA equal to 1 by 3. Similar distribution factor of BC, what will be the distribution factor of BC? BC equal to, what is the relative stiffness of BC? 2I by 4. So 2I by 4 divided by 3I by 4, which is total relative stiffness, you'll get 2 by 3. So calculation is here. So now you have a check. So distribution factor of BA is 1 by 3. Distribution factor of BC equal to 2 by 3. If you add it, you should get 1. That is a check. See, 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3 is 3 by 3, 1. So it is correct. So this is how you find it is correct. So yeah, the points to be noted here is, at a joint, the sum of distribution factors is 1, and distribution factor is calculated only for intermediate joints. And now we'll see that this table, this formula table. So condition for and fixed. See here, AB. AB is a for and fixed. Relative stiffness equal to I by L. Carrier factor equal to, carrier moment equal to M by 2. Carrier factor equal to 1 by 2. Stiffness is, only stiffness is 4A by L. Okay, that you'll know. For and hinge means, relative stiffness equal to 3 by 4 I by L. And carrier moment equal to 0. Carrier factor also 0. Now, for and hinge. See the for and? For and B is hinged. Say AB, for end is B. But it is continuous. So this case is similar to for end fixed. So again, you'll have relative stiffness I by L and carrier moment is M by 2. Okay. So remember this table. Hope it was interesting. The next class we'll have a problem. And then we'll have the procedure. So after solving the problem only, it'll be easy to have the procedure for this moment distribution method. Hope you all understood. Thank you.